You think video editing is complicated? I'm gonna prove you wrong. So in this video, I'm gonna take you over to my computer. We're gonna go through Descript and I'm gonna show you how to use AI to edit video quickly and easily. Let's go.
So let's dig into Descript. So I'm on Descript on my computer right now. And you can see once you have it loaded in, and by the way, there's a free version, there's a paid version. I have the paid version because I use it all the time, but you can start with the free version. So when you first start off, what you're gonna do, there's a bunch of options. The easiest thing is to hit new project. And you're going to select if it's a video or audio project. So if it's a video project, which a lot of you probably are using video for, you can just upload your file right here. Now, if you have an iPhone, I often, and if you're recording on your phone, I often will just airdrop my videos from my phone to my computer. That's kind of the easiest way to do it. If you don't have an iPhone, you can always put your videos in Google Drive or Dropbox and then access them on your computer and then upload them. So you're going to upload them right here. I'm not going to actually do that right now because it does take a little bit of time. But for the sake of this example, I'm going to show a video that I've already uploaded to show you just honestly how easy this is when it comes to the AI video editing process. Okay, so let's pull up this video and you can title it. I number all my videos just to keep it easy. And then I just put Descript just so I know that this is just doing a little demo to show what Descript is. So when you upload your video, it takes a couple minutes to upload. And one of the things that's cool is it's going to transcribe your whole video. So on the left-hand side, you can see this whole transcription, which is really cool. Now, one of the ways you can edit through Descript, if you wanted to manually, you could actually read through. And then if there's certain things you don't like you're like, oh, I don't want to say this word right here, you can highlight it. And then you can actually go up here and hit that little sort of line that goes through it. And it's going to take it out of your video. So it's still there if you change your mind. So you could actually go through and manually do this, which is fine, but that does take a lot of time. What I want to show you really quick is the AI part of this, which is so cool. Okay, so take your video, you upload it. And I record a lot of my videos outside, which means there's like flying over, there's the wind. And I do, and this is something I started doing recently, was recording outside, but how do we clean it up? Okay, on the right-hand side, there are a bunch of different AI tools. The first thing I usually pick is this button that says studio sound. So when you hit the studio sound button, it's going to go through your video and just clean up the sound. You guys, it's going to sound amazing. So instead of like the wind whipping or whatever, it's going to clean up the sound, which is awesome. So let's go back to that AI tool right here. And again, I usually click studio sound. I've already done this. So it's already kind of nothing to fix because I already fixed it, but that's what you're going to do. Okay. So then we're going to go back. And there's basically just a few buttons that I always do. So I do studio sound, it's going to clean up the sound. Then I usually hit this button that says edit for clarity. And you can actually pick low, medium, or heavy. And basically what it's going to do is it's going to just make your video a lot more concise. I usually like to put it on the low setting, but if I know I was doing a video and just kind of probably would put it on medium. But if you either low, medium, or heavy, and then you can hit submit and it's going to think a minute. Okay, it's going to look at your video and you can see it's going to basically pick out certain things that you could take out. And it's, you look at the left-hand side, you can see that there's already stuff that's grayed out. This is stuff that AI already picked, but there's some other things. So if I look at the right-hand side, it's picked 21 things and I has already manually taken them out. So if I'm like, cool, good to go, that's fine. I like to look through these and go, yeah, do I want to keep it or do I want to delete it? So if I want to keep it, you're just going to hit the check mark. It's going to accept that edit. If you don't want to do it, then you can hit the X button to discard it. So I'm just going to kind of through. And again, you're going to want to read through. Usually it's going to kind of your video. It's going to take out the ums and the ahs. Okay. So I would go through all that. And then I'm going to go back over here, go back to AI tools. Click on that, take that out. Okay. We did the studio sound, edited for clarity. Let's see here. Okay. Already did that. Awesome. So now we're going to go to the third one. Let's go back here. There we go. Remove filler words. Okay. So this is like the ums and the ahs and the likes and the so's. Again, I already did this. So there's probably going to be no results because it basically already did that. But if you scroll through, you'll see it picked up a lot of the ums and the ahs and the little filler words that just make your video kind of on or not, right? The goal of editing your video is to get people to watch your full video and it makes it easier when it's tighter and there's less of the ums and the ahs. Okay, so we've edited for clarity, we've fixed the sound, removed filler words. If you do a lot of retakes, I don't do a lot of retakes, but if you're someone who's like, I'm going to retake, you can actually click that and it'll remove your... This next one is shorten word gaps. So often when I'm doing a video, I'm like looking at the camera and then I look down at my notes, read what I'm going to say, and then I look back up. I personally don't use a teleprompter, so I often will have word gaps. So if you hit this, it's going to look for any word gaps. Again, I've already done this, so there's no results. but there are some word gaps. And then they took, you know, shortened up some of those little 1 second or 2 second word gaps. Chapters, that's not something I necessarily do, but usually these first four, the first five, awesome. If that's all you do with your video, it's going to just that alone make your video so much better. So especially if you are talking straight to camera, you're sharing a helpful tip, or maybe you're doing like a house tour, or you're doing, you know, you're showcasing your community and you've got some video. You can also add in multiple clips. I typically just have one video like this, but if you've got in some different videos, you can pull in different video clips if you'd like. I just like to kind of simple, and I primarily use Descript for videos where I am sharing helpful content, where I'm talking straight to camera, which if you followed me for any period of time, you know that I really feel like that's got to be an important part of your content mix. You're probably already creating some content with listings and open houses. Awesome. That's a different type of video. These are like sort of lead generating videos, right? So again, you've got these AI tools right here. The other thing that you can do, if I scroll down, you can also, if you see this button right here, it says repurpose. You guys know I'm all about repurposing. So you can actually, I love this first button that says create clips. And there's different layouts that you can actually pick. There's lots of different layouts here. It'll show you what that looks like. So you can pick a different layout that you like. And then you hit submit, and it's basically going to create a lot of different clips for you. And I think I already did this. Let me double check. Did I already do this? No, I didn't do this. So if I click, let's say I want this particular look right here. And again, you can kind of through. And I love taking, especially long form video, and turning it into shorter form video. So if I hit submit, it's probably going to take a minute here, but it's going to create a multitude of clips based on this longer video. So if you've got a longer YouTube video, or you've got, maybe you've done a Zoom where you've got yourself and you're interviewing someone and it's a long piece of content, again, upload it into Descript, use the AI tools to clean up the sound, clean up the ums and ahs, clean up the word gaps, and then you can repurpose it. So just like that, look at that. Now I've got three little clips and I can click on any one of these. Let's click on this one. And it's going to have, you know, show you kind of looks like. Let me see if I can click on this one here really quick. It's going to show you. Here we go. Okay, it takes a little bit of a second. I don't know why this one looks green. So let's go to the second one. Okay, here's a little clip right here. And it's going to show you at the top of the screen what the name of that video is, Repurpose Your Old Content. Given us a name, which is cool. It's given us a, and if I wanted to with this caption, I could actually click on this color and change the color. So if I wanted to change it to yellow or my brand color, like actually put my brand colors in here, which is kind of cool. I could move the video around if it wasn't like centered, but same thing. And again, I don't know why this green is showing up. That's a little weird. I would dig into that, but might just be pulling the color background or something. I love that you can just repurpose and grab some clips right there. Maybe if I just delete that green, there we go. For some reason, there's like a green overlay. There we go. I just deleted it. Awesome. So sometimes, I don't know why, there was a little green overlay. Click that, delete it. Awesome. So now I've got five different clips and they all have a different title, right? Which is cool. And I would also read through them, make sure that those are clips I want to use. Let's delete that little thing there. All right, cool. And so now I've got, you know, five clips that I'm like ready to go. So when I'm in Descript, if I click up here at the top, you can see here are those four or five. I deleted one of them because I was like, not great. So now I've got four clips that I could use for Reels or TikToks, which is cool. And then if I wanted to download any of them, like if I wanted to download it, I could just click export up at the top, right? And then you're going to hit a little arrow right here, which is going to download it to your computer. I'm looking at my face here. I don't know why I'm making a face in that video. And if you wanted to download the full one, you just go back to that full video here. Let's click home and let's go back to that full video, and you could download the full video also. So, well, now it's taking a second to think. There we go. Okay. We could click export and then I could download that full video. So now I've got that full video, which is 5 minutes, but now I also have four or five short little clips to use for TikTok or Reels. Easy. The other thing I'm going to mention really quick, to wrap this up, is so we talked about the AI piece, and there's obviously a lot more you could do, right? I'm just covering the simplest things. I could do all this in 10 minutes, upload the video, edit for clarity, studio sound, remove filler words, remove retakes, and find four or five clips, done. Now in 10 minutes, I have one long form piece of content and like four or five short clips, right? Awesome. Save them to your computer. I like to save them to my computer and just put them in a folder. And then when you look at your content calendar, figure out, okay, what is going to get published, right? And ideally with a content calendar, you've already kind of an idea of like those five topics that you're recording, because I like to batch record, right? I'll set aside an hour once a week or once a month, record, and then I've got those and I'm good to go. Okay. Last thing I just want to mention really fast is, let me go up to AI. Oh, export. You can also grab the transcript. Okay. This is awesome, you guys. One quick tip I'm going to give you. I often will grab the transcript. I will copy it to my clipboard, and then I'll go over to GPT and I'll put something like, hey, here's a transcript for recent video about X, Y, and Z. Here's the transcript. Can you create an email newsletter? Can you create a LinkedIn article? Can you create a caption for Reels or whatever it might be? Let me see if I can actually pull this up really quick and show you really quick what I'm talking about. Let me stop sharing my screen, go full screen, and let's go back here really quick and just show you really quick. So if I go into chatgpt.com and I say something like, I am going to the transcript of a YouTube video I just recorded, please create and optimize and search, that stands for search engine optimized, title, description, and keywords. Okay. I'm going to paste in that whole transcription, hit enter. And this is one of the things I love using AI for. It's my words, right? It's me, but now I'm using ChatGPT to like take my words and turn it into an SEO optimized title, right? So here's a title, here's a description, here's search engine. And again, read it over, double check it, right? But I feel like this is going to get you half the way there. I could even take it a step further and say, you turn this into a email newsletter, LinkedIn newsletter, and a blog post. Okay. You can kind of going with that one piece of content, right? And guess what? Those four or five clips that you created on Descript, those have their own transcriptions too. So you can take those and go, okay, create a caption for Instagram or TikTok, right? So now I've got an email newsletter. I've got a LinkedIn newsletter. It's going to keep going and going. So again, I mainly wanted to show you Descript, but honestly, Descript for me works really great hand in hand with ChatGPT, because again, it's one piece of content turned into a multitude of things. And again, we're going to read it over and double check.
So there you go. Descript is quick and easy to use. I'm not affiliated with Descript, by the way. There's other great tools that you can use like captions.ai, Canva, CapCut, but pick a tool and really dig into the AI stuff. I think it's one of the best ways to use AI. Nobody, I think, should be spending hours and hours editing video unless you're maybe a full-time content creator. But if you're an entrepreneur or realtor watching this, pick one of these tools, use it, dig in. A couple other quick things I want to mention real fast. Just have a workflow, you know, trim out the pauses like we talked about, add captions. You don't worry about over editing, get yourself in a routine, keep it simple. All right, let me know what you think. Do you have any questions? Are you using Descript? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you soon. Bye for now.